All right, guys. Rob Anderson, Clean Power Wash. I want to show you some of the maintenance stuff and kind of the basic troubleshooting for booster pumps. I believe both of these are the 3/4, and we'll show you some of the 1-horse in just a moment. But this one's already got it off. This is what it looks like internally. If this shaft ever gets bent, you're done. Most times what'll happen is that in the course of using it, you may either start tripping a circuit breaker, or the quick connects, not your quick connects, but your tips are getting clogged with little pieces of plastic. So on here, these are the diffusers. I'll show you these here. This one, we've actually had it in oxalic acid that kind of cleaned it up. Let that sit in there. I'll try not to bust this, but. So this is what the internals are. You've got your disc, basically. You've got your impeller, and then your diffuser. What'll happen most times is that these will end up getting brittle. They'll crack, especially the clear plastic ones or semi-transparent ones. Once they crack, or if this outer rim starts getting really crisp, crunchy, I'm just gonna toss it. These are pretty cheap. They're like $3 or $4 a piece. I think these ones, actually this version is a little bit more expensive, different material, it's supposed to last longer. If they do crack, you'll also tend to have little pieces of broken plastic inside here. You can either use your dental pick, or I like to use just the air compressor, blow that out. And when you're cleaning them out, this kind of stuff, you can put some chemical on it, let it sit, and then just clean it out, green scrubby sponge or whatever on there, and that all goes on here. On the sleeve, there's one more piece that'll go on the outside right here. So that would be a complete cylinder. In here, when we go to service it, there is one clip. You take your needle nose pliers and you pop that off. And you want to make sure that as you're taking these off, that you actually count how many of the little discs or spacers that'll be in there. Usually there's 4 to 5, 6 in there. They're supposed to be tuned, so each set really is designed for its specific one. We also found out that this one, you can see I've got some of the I forget what the name of this is, but the different diffusers, ones the two different variations of them. You're supposed to stick with the same kind through it, because they are just a fraction of whatever bigger or smaller than. So I'll show you back here. So I bought a whole bunch of booster pumps for testing them. The basics are, first of all, plug it in. Does it run? Does it sound like it's humming along? If it's not, that's an indication that you've got stuff binding up in here. You'll hear it really loud if the stuff inside it if you hear any grinding, if you hear stuff, that's not good for it. A lot of times with all these, they have pro switches on them. These are all the 5 GVS, so 5 gallon minute boosters. These ones are specifically from Power Wash Store. We get them from Power Wash Store or Manatee Supply down in Florida. You can also see a couple of these are all the same style pro switch with a shorter jumper hose. In this configuration, where you have a 1-inch outlet, comes down to 3/4-inch male. You got your 3/4-inch T. These are all cam locks, so you can take them off and on each rig pretty quickly. Coming out here, and then so we've got 3/4 male, 3/4, 3/4 male out, and then a garden hose adapter right here to go from male pipe thread to garden hose thread. If we want to service one of these, we'll loosen this, take the pro switch off. I'm going to take this whole portion off, which first you'll take off the actual garden hose connection of it. take that off. These are reverse threaded, and you can see rotation. You actually would, left is tight, right's loose, and you want to actually get it on the center portion of it. If it's still bolted down, you can actually take this, and you want to use both hands to torque it or use a pipe wrench, but you don't want to, most times you can't get away with that here. I've actually had a bunch of success down there, but either way. This one, we'll be converting it, so it'll be the same as all these other ones. The other typical issues with these, so this would be if one we're having priming issues, we want to check right here. We want to make sure that this check valve is still good. We can just take this off. The nice thing is the way this is set up, we take these cam locks off. We can go ahead and twist this whole unit and check it. A lot of times force feeding water can help you as well. You want to make sure too, when these are getting put together, that we're not overdoing it on the Teflon tape. One, because it'll change the size of it, but two, because we don't want to get any of the Teflon tape into there. So you'll actually leave one or two threads without any Teflon tape on it. But making sure your check valves are good. And these will actually separate for your bottom and or top and bottom, however you want to look at it. These ones all have the priming valves on top of them to go from your bleach and proportioner to just the water side. And you switch that around either way. We'll also be standardizing some of these are chem locks out. It's actually easier if your fittings, if these are actually the male plugs, because you can't always get these as tight on as you need to that way. And sometimes, depending on your knob style, that can be a pain as well in there. So these will all end up looking exactly the same. The next part that you'll troubleshoot, electric-wise, make sure, and you can look in here, depending on your style booster, this may or not have this, but whether or not it keeps instantly tripping when you're plugged in, I recommend to put a surge protector, plug that into your wall outlet, and then run that through it. That way it's a quick, easy flip. You don't have to go back to your to the circuit breaker box to undo that. The next thing that'll usually go is your on-off valve, or your on-off power toggle. Open this up inside. If this is bad, it's usually completely melted, and it's very obvious that you need to replace that. This is just a screw to take off. The backside, you do have additional wiring going on in there, and there's with these ones, also make sure before any time that you're servicing these that you force feed water through the whole system so you don't end up with leftover roof mix that your employees forgot to tell you was still in there. And also, if it's going to be sitting a while you're troubleshooting it, you want to do that. These ones on the back do have a way that you can actually spin the internals by taking a screw through there, and if you hear a crunching sound, you know you may be able to get through that job, but your diffusers are toast. That's the bulk of what you'll deal with on these pro switches, making sure that this stuff is all wired right. This was already came to us pre-wired, so we don't have to worry about that. We have set up some of ours. Without pro switches, we just did an on-off remote kill switch, which worked okay until employees forget to press on-off. The only other thing on these two that you can do, you've got four bolts. Depending on your access, just undoing that bolt and the other one that's on the other side can be the easiest way to take this whole thing off. You see none of these have the actual bottom frame that holds it. You just take those bottom two bolts off, and then everything else is accessible. Making sure that these are still good too. This is another failure point in these. Cleaning them up, opening this up, you can just take your screws out. See that those connections are nice and tight. Periodically, especially since this is usually going to be in a wet environment, put some dielectric grease on it, or just even taking and scraping those off. That's the basics of troubleshooting and going through with a booster pump.